Dig pa ano na present. So, good afternoon, everyone. We are the second group, and our report is all about Lesson 1, Foundation of Physical Education and Health. So, yung first reporter po is si Dig Angelo. Sunod po si Refugio Daniel, and panghuli po si Torsar Generals. Next slide, be. Ayan, sidig mo na po.
So, good afternoon everyone. So, we're finally moving on to Unit 2 to our physical education and health. So, alongside with Mrs. Torzar and Ms. Refugio, we're about to discuss Lesson 1, the foundation of physical education and health and history itself. So, before we start, let's have a game first. So here lies the answer that were partially covers some related topic or key points that were about to discuss. So magdaroon na. So assume meron siyang prize yata eh. Yung prize namin is ano daw, sa Monday pa daw. Surprise daw sabi. Sabi ng mga group member ko. So anyone, sinong makapag...
Janice.
Sino po? Patasan ang naman. Okay, Janice po.
Physical education.
Okay, physical education. Tama. So, next.
Carabeo.
Ebales. Hindi ko narinig. Okay, Ebales.
Health.
Okay, tingnan natin kung tama ba yan. Okay, tama. Health. Galing ulod sa. So, next one. Sino pwede mag-serve?
Carabeo.
Okay, Carabeo.
Foundation.
Ano po? Foundation. Ano man sagot? Foundation po?
Oo.
Okay, tiga natin. Tama, foundation. Next. Sino
Mota. Mapa?
Okay, Mota.
Motor behavior.
Motor behavior, tama nga ba? Tama. So, last one po. Sino po makapagsagot?
Neverio.
Okay, ate, Neverio.
History.
Okay, tama. History, ang galing mo. Sa objectives po. So, at the end of the lesson, you will be able to discuss the foundation of physical education and health and define motor behavior, differentiate the focus, purpose, and target people of physical education and health through time, and distinguish the benefits of learning, the foundation of physical education and health.
So, ayan. Thank you, Dig. So, bago tayo magpatuloy sa pinakatalakayan, babasahin ko muna yung introduction ng physical education. So, in physical education and health are important parts of every pupil's life In this subject, pupils learn about different activities that are beneficial for their body, like physical fitness, games, and sport. On the other hand, concepts included in health education help pupils learn about healthy habits, like selecting and eating healthy foods. The subject have a colorful milestone that will serve as the foundation for teaching the subject. The service teacher must acquire knowledge about the foundation of PE and health for them to provide a curriculum instruction that are congruent to the concept that their future pupils need to learn. They need to understand the importance of this subject and how this can help them have a healthy disposition, which may lead to a productive life in the future. Hence, this lesson will discuss the foundation of physical education and health, as well as other pivotal matters with regards to this subject.
So moving on to historical foundation of physical education. So historical, from the word itself, history. So it is a timeline, so through generation sa physical education. So sa pamamagitan ng kasaysayan, bibigyan daan tayo paunawaan kung paano tayo na-influensya ng mga ating nakaraang ninuno or pinuno ng mga kaganapan sa physical fitness noong sinaunang panahon. Tulad ng science exercise at mga iba pang sports. So, tinuturo rin sa atin ng history of physical activity ay tungkol sa pagbabago pati na rin sa ating katatagan sa nakaraan. At nakakatulong ito sa atin na maunawaan ang kasalukuyan at gumawa ng mga makatwirang desisyon para sa inaharap. Siyempre, alam naman natin na ang kasaysayan din ang nagsisilbing sanggunian na nagmumungkay sa mga posibleng posibilidad at mga kurso ng pagkilos na maaaring maging matagumpay sa mga susunod na inaharap. So, yun nga, history educate us by allowing us to comprehend how past leaders and events influence physical fitness, exercise science, and sports. So history serves as a reference, suggesting possibilities of course of action that could be more successful in the years ahead. So history is an academic discipline. So when you say discipline, dito is subject. So academic discipline concerned with the study of transition over time. So historian do analysis that is both informative and interpretive. So bakit nga ba natin kailangan pag-aralan to? Kasi when you study the past, you're able to understand the process of education and how it evolved up to the present. So in this way, the present not only becomes clear but also help us to illuminate the future. So in ancient Greek, prehistoric times before Christ, 338 before Christ, and Rome, 500 to 27 BC or before Christ. So Greece, particularly in the state of Athens, gives a high importance of physical activity, viewing sports, exercise, and fitness as essential to education and life. So they believe that education consists of intellectual and physical development, and the expression of a sound in mind in a sound body. So this illustrates their belief. So they have also the gymnasium that serve as the yung sentro ng discussion ng sports instruction and physical training, as well as wrestling, running, jumping, na kadalasang tinuturo to sa mga kalalakihan nung panahon ng ancient Greece, no? So kung makikita natin, physical activities taught to male, So madalang lang tayo makita na mga babaeng nabibuild up na mga muscle nila through to this generation kasi bakit nga ba? Kasi yung physique ng lalaki mas malakas sa physique ng babae. So alam naman natin 'yun. So ayun, so Greek held the festival in honor of the gods. So where sports sporting events enable Greek men to show off their physical beauty as well as their athletic abilities. So Greek sa Greece, no? Kung makikita naman natin, no? Sa yung mga rebulto sa mga Greece kung paano nila pine-flex yung mga ano nila, mga physique nila, yung mga body nila, no? Kung makikita mo puro ano talaga, build up talaga yung ano nila, yung mga muscles nila. So ayun, mas binibigyan nila ng pansin yung ano yung katawan nila pero hindi sila yung more on brutality na nakikipaglaban sa kapwa nila tao. So ginagamit nila yung physical education hindi lang din sa katawan nila. Nakakatulong rin to sa pag-build up ng ano nila ng intellectual sa mga discussion. So yun. So physical activity was also valued in Asian Roman era. So ibig sabihin sinakop rin, alam ko sinakop sila ng Roman na yung Greece. So through do it play the different role than Greece, fitness and physical prowess were critical to Rome's military victory. So many physical activities such as archery, wrestling, horseback riding and fencing were that to male. So male na naman. So wala ka halos makita ng babaeng sumusubok mag-train ng physical education kasi it's more about parang palakasan ng katawan. So ayun. So as Rome continued to extend its empire, so physical activities were critical to growing men's strength. So they could be effective in defending the states and fighting war. So ayun, sa Rome kasi yung definition nila ng physical education is more on brutality. Sinabi nga dito fighting wars, diba? Eh sa Greece naman is more on about parang competition ayun to, pero parang ganun kasi lumalabas. So yun, Greek gymnastics were introduced to people after Rome invade Greece. Yun nga. So, dahil sa pag-invade nga ng Rome sa Greece, nabago yung pamamalakad ng physical education sa Greece. Pero hindi rin siya naging matagumpay, hindi siya masyadong na-impluensyahan, pero hindi ganun kalaki yung sakop ng. So, ayun, but they were not well received. Professional sports such as gladiatorial battles, men fighting wild animals, and men fighting to death were common among Romans. So yun nga, diba? Sabi, men fighting to death were common among Romans. Ibig sabihin itong mga Romans na to, more on sila, brutality sila, diba? Ginagamit nila yung physical, body nila, or yung definition ng physical education nila is more on fighting. So, these and other games such as chariot race were well attended by spectators as well as lack of physical activity. So yon. Pero diba sinakop sila ng Roman, pero yung Roman Empire eventually bumagsak sila dahil nga sa poor physical condition na naging factor para bumagsak yung Roman Empire sa Cristo. So in early modern European program, so in Germany, physical education in Germany during the early modern Europe era was focused on the creation of strong people through programs in school and community organization. So Johann Bernhard Beisdow and Johann Christoph Friedrich Gottsmatz and other spies, all pioneers of physical education at that time, were instrumental in encouraging school gymnastics. So their programs emphasized gymnastic games, marching, running, and wrestling were drills and training in the sports. This leader claims that the physical education deserved to be included in school curriculum. So sinabi na ang physical education kailangan siyang ilagay sa ano. Sabi ng itong tatlong name na to na naging leader sa Germany para magtatag ng organization para sa physical education is ang physical education dapat daw siya na ilagay sa curriculum. Bakit nga ba? So, ayun, siguro sa tatlong to, nakita nila na ang physical education ay important part of students' education because it helped them to stay healthy and learn teamwork skills. So, in addition, physical education can help students maintain health weight and develop lifelong physical activity habits. So, itong tatlong pangalan na to na si Johann Bernhard Bass daw, siya yung nagtatag ng paaralan na tinatawag na philanthropinum. PHILANTHROPINUM. So ito yung kauna-unahang paaralan sa modern Europe na nag-aalok ng isang program na ang physical education daw ay dapat maging bahagi ng or dapat maging bahagi ng curriculum. And si ano naman si Johann Christoph Friedrich Gott. So isa rin siyang founder ng physical education. So he is often referred to as one of the founder of physical education in Germany. So si Christoph Friedrich sumulat din siya ng dalawang libro para sa physical education na pinamagatan na Gymnastic for Young and Games na naglalaman ng mga paglalaro na pabor sa mga institusyon ng physical education. And last, si Adolf Spies noong 1819 to 1858. So, isa rin siyang founder ng school gymnastic sa Germany. So, tinutulungan niya rin yung he helped to make physical education a part of school life. So, yun. Dahil nga sa physical education in modern Europe ay makikita sa contribution ng mga bansang ito na sa paglago at pangalan ng mga nag-aambag nito.
Thank you.